everybody. It's your girl, Jess Cookie, aka A Real Cookie, here to bring you another confession. Have you peeped my scenery? This is the traveling sofa. No matter where, she and I will go to give you guys the confession. We out you. Anyway, I open up the confessions to you guys this week. I asked, what did you want to hear about? Because like I said, I've lived, and more than likely, I've gone through your questions. Today's question comes directly from a Twitter request. Tell us about your first BDR. What is a BDR? Bad dick report. Yikes! So anyway, this story happened some time ago with the person that I've been knowing. So it wasn't like I just randomly selected somebody to have sex with. But anyway, the difference between this sexual encounter versus any other one that I had, this is the first time that I actually went into it expecting something. I had a fantasy that I wanted to play out. Don't judge me. And that's exactly what it was. I wanted the candle lights, the soft music, the roses, the drinks. I wanted to dance. Hell, I even wanted him to crawl to me. All right? Don't judge me again. But in essence, all of those things happened. I did get my dance. I even remember the song that he danced to, 12 Plays by R. Kelly. All right? He was fine too. So I was like, yeah, it's about to go down in this thing. Son got the dance going on. You know, the room is set. I had my little negligee on. Yes, me in a negligee. I was so freaking paranoid that I had to call on my dogs, who been having my back since day one, help a real cookie pick out some drawers. Because I don't know nothing about that life. Me, I just hangs her way it out and be done. That's how I roll. So anyway, back to the setting. In the midst of the dance, he started talking shit. Like, I don't remember the exact dialogue. Y'all gonna make me lie about that. But it was something to the effect that I'm about to tear that ass up. That's what I got out of whatever he was saying. His body was saying he was about to tear that ass up. So I was like, kind of like, I'm almost reneged. I almost said, no, I don't want to do it. Because I'm a cowardice cookie sometimes. But I went through with it. So immediately into the intercourse part of the night, I started having some reservations. Like, this ain't what I thought it was going to be. It wasn't like on and popping physically as it had been in my mind. So maybe that's where it went wrong for me. Maybe it was better than what I'm telling you guys, but I know that it wasn't good. I wasn't into it. I didn't finish. He did. Quickly. All right. And as soon as he did, I basically just threw him off of me. And I was like, what did I just do? So I went and took a bath. That's what girls do. We take baths afterwards. And I just sat in the tub for a long time. I know I was in there for a long time because the water turned cold. Even after refilling it with hot water, it was still cold. That means I had to use up all the hot water. I was wrinkle city because I didn't really know what to do. I didn't know how to go back in the room and deal with that. Like, if I had been mature, I would have just kited up out of there immediately after. No ranch off, no nothing. Just go. But I didn't. I stayed. And like I said, we were friends. And the room had a double bed. So when I came out, he was in one bed. That was my cue to get in the other bed. He kind of smirked a little bit, like, really? But I did. I did that. I got in the other bed. Then sometime after that, I dozed off. And then my phone rung, maybe about 2-ish, 3 in the morning. I answered the phone. It was his mama calling because I was the last number on her caller ID box. And she was trying to see if I was with him so I could tell him to bring her back her car. So on top of being unfulfilled, unsatisfied, I had to now wake your ass up to tell you that your mama looking for her car. Just icing to a perfectly not good night. So he got dressed, I got dressed, silence in the room. We got in the elevator, silence in the elevator. We got out that mug on our way to our separate cars, silence. I don't even remember saying goodnight to him. And I don't remember how long it took for us to start talking again after that awkward moment. That's another reason why you don't have sex with friends, just randomly, just throwing that out there. But we didn't talk for a really long time, but it didn't ruin our friendship. We are still friends today. It's just that I never double back. I don't know what son working with today. I don't care to know. I can't say what his life is like now. So whatever you got going on, shout out to you. I just know from my experience, and maybe it was me. I don't know. I could have been the bad cookie reporter. I don't know. Maybe I could have done more. But all in all, it wasn't the best. And that's mainly probably because I expected it to be awesome. And it wasn't awesome. So that's my confession. That's my first BDR. Has that been my last? Stay tuned to the confessions to find out more from a real cookie. In the meantime, catch the radio show weekly. Kev, Mark, and myself, Cookie Jaw, 7 to 9, JustCookie.com, MindStarsRadio.com, or tune in radio, MindStars Radio. This has been a confession from a real cookie, a real unsatisfied cookie. And we out of here. Peace.